Yeah, good afternoon. Good afternoon to all. So today we'll discuss about sorting techniques. Okay, so before discussing about the techniques, first let us learn what is sorting. Okay, so sorting refers to the operation of arranging data. When you have some data and you need to arrange that data in some given order. Okay, so in case of, say, for example, you have numerical data, then you need to arrange that data either in increasing order or decreasing order. Or if you have a character data, then you need to arrange that data in alphabetical order. And such operation is known as a sorting. We can define sorting in this way. Sorting refers to the operation of arranging data in some given order, such as increasing or decreasing with numerical data or alphabetically with character data. So sorting takes an unordered collection of data, unordered collection of data, and makes it an ordered one. For example, I have some data in an array A. Okay, and if you observe 77, 42, 35, 12, 101, and 8, they are not in order. Okay, so this is called unordered collection. Now, if you perform sorting on this, then this will turn into an ordered collection. Okay, so now you can see after performing the sorting, now the data is arranged in ascending order. 8, 12, 35, 42, 77, 101. This is called sorting. Okay, so how to arrange data in this increasing order, decreasing order? Okay, so for that we have different techniques: bubble sort, selection sort, and insertion sort as per your syllabus. So today we'll talk about a bubble sort technique. So let us assume that A is a list of n numbers as seen in previous slide. Okay, so A is an array containing list of n numbers. Suppose the list of numbers A of 1, A of 2 up to A of n is in memory. Okay, so assume that A, array A, is stored in memory. Okay, so for discussion purpose, we take the first element as A of 1, second element as A of 2. That way, the last element is at A of n position. Okay, so this is for discussion purpose. Internally, implementation wise, it may be different. Okay, so first we'll see how bubble sort works and sorts the given numbers. So the bubble sort algorithm works as follows. So in the first step, compare A of 1 and A of 2. Okay, so that means compare first element and the second element and arrange them in the order so that A of 1 is less than A of 2. Okay, so in that order, you arrange the first two element such that the first element A of 1 is less than A of 2. Okay, so that means we'll start by comparing first two elements, then compare second and third element. Second element will be at A of 2 position and third element will be at A of 3 position. Okay, so then compare A of 2 and A of 3 and arrange them so that A of 2 is less than A of 3. Okay, so in that order you arrange it. That means if they are not in the order, then you compare and then arrange them in order such that, in which order, such that A of 2 is less than A of 3. Okay, so first two elements we compared, then second and third element we compared. Okay, so then compare third and fourth element. Like this, pairwise comparisons we need to perform. Okay, so then compare A of 3 and A of 4 and arrange them so that A of 3 is less than A of 4. Okay, so like this, continue until we compare last two elements. Where are the last two elements stored? A of n minus 1 and A of n. The last element is at A of n, last but one element is at A of n minus 1. Okay, so like this, we'll go on compare two elements one after the other and we reach to last two elements. Continue this process until we compare A of n minus 1 with A of n and arrange them so that A of n minus 1 is less than A of n. Okay, so starting from first element onwards, we started comparing 2 elements and finally we compared the last two elements and arranged them in order. Okay, so this completes first step. Okay, so that means you need to start from the first element and you need to reach the last element and go on compare pairwise. Okay, so after first step, the largest element is bubbled up to the nth position. Okay, so if you see, the largest element will move on to the last position, that is nth position. Okay, so that means it is bubbled up, it is coming up, you can see. Okay, so when step one is completed, A of n will contain the largest element. The largest element will be moved to the rightmost position in the array. Okay, so this is step one. Then only one element moved to its position, rightmost position. So then what about other elements? They are not again in order. So you have to repeat the same comparisons. Okay, but this time you repeat step one with one less comparison. Why one less comparison? Because already the rightmost element, nth position element, is in its place. Okay, so that you should not disturb again. Okay, so but one, starting from first element to but one element, you need to last but one element, you need to compare. Okay, so that's why step two says that repeat step one with one less comparison. That is, now we stop after we compare and possibly rearrange A of n minus 2 and A of n minus 1. Okay, so again you should start from first two element onwards, A of 1, A of 2, compare and arrange them, A of 2, A of 3. Like this, you have to go up to A of n minus 2 and A of n minus 1, because A of n is already in its position. Okay, so one less comparison you have to perform and you need to arrange. When step 2 is completed, the second largest element will occupy A of n minus 1. Okay, so from right second position, the second largest element will occupy. Okay, right. So again step 3. So after step 2, two elements occupies their positions from the right. Okay, nth position and n minus 1 position, the largest two elements will be occupied there. Okay, so what about other elements? Again, you need to repeat the process. Okay, so in step 3, this is called as each step, or we can also call them as pass, pass 1, pass 2, pass 3 also we can call them as. Okay, so repeat step 1 with two less comparisons this time, because already two elements are in their positions. Okay, so that is, we stop after we compare and possibly rearrange A of n minus 3 and A of n minus 2. Okay, so after step 3, the third largest element will occupy A of n minus 2 position. Okay, so like this, we need to repeat step 4, step 5. Like this, we have to go on until we reach step n minus 1. If there are n elements, then the last step will be n minus 1 step. Okay, so in n minus 1 step, what we'll do, we'll left with only the first two elements, A of 1 and A of 2, because we are going to arrange the numbers, highest elements from right to left onwards. Okay, so rightmost to next rightmost, like this, we are pushing highest elements to their positions from the right. So that means when we reach step n minus 1, we come to two elements, A of 1 and A of 2. So you compare these two and arrange them so that A of 1 is less than A of 2. Okay, so here we stop after step n minus 1, we stop here. So after n minus 1 step, the list will be sorted. Okay, so automatically the list will be sorted. Clear? So this is bubble sorter algorithm. Okay, so if you have n elements, n minus 1 steps are in n minus 1 passes, the list will be sorted in bubble sort. Okay, so we'll see an example. So here, bubble sort main technique is what? Bubbling up the largest element. Bubbling up the largest element, nothing but moving the largest element to the rightmost position. Or in other words, why the name means, if you pour these elements into water, bucket of water, the highest element will bubble up first, then the next highest element will bubble up first. That is the technique we are applying here. Okay, so that is what we are performing in this array. Okay, so in step one, traverse collection of elements, move from the start to the end. That means first element to last element you move, bubble the largest value to the end using pairwise comparisons and swapping. So every time do pairwise comparisons and finally bubble up the largest value. Okay, now if you take the example, assume our array contains these elements 77, 42, 35, 12, 101 and Yay. Now I'm starting step one. So in step one, you need to start from A of 1 and A of 2. Okay, so that means first two elements you need to compare here. So 77 greater than 42? Yes. So what do you need to do? You need to swap these two numbers. So what happens? 42 comes to first position and 77 goes to next position. Okay, so that means you arranged them in sorting order such that A of 1 is less than A of 2. A of 1 is less than A of 2 now. Okay, so then go to next two elements, second and third elements you compare. Again, so A of 2 greater than A of 3? Yes. So again, you need to swap such that 35 comes to second position and 77 goes to third position. Okay, so what you are doing, now you arranged second and third elements in the order, in ascending order, right? So then go to third and fourth element, 77 and 12. 77 greater than 12? Yes. So whenever the leftmost element is greater, or you can say that these two are not in order. So you need to swap them. So immediately swap them. 12 comes here, 77 goes there. Yes. So then compare fourth and fifth element this time. Now 77 less than 101? Yes. That means they are already in order, ascending order. These two numbers only. Okay. So no need to swap. So then go to fifth and sixth element. So 101 greater than 8? Yes. So in this case, that means they are not in order. These two numbers are not in order. So you need to swap. So 8 comes here, 101 goes to the right position. Okay. So that means after step 1, the largest element in the list moved to the last position. 101 moved to 6th position here. Just see here. Largest value correctly placed here. Okay. Now if you observe the list, if you notice, only the largest value is correctly placed. Only this number 101 is correctly placed in its position. All other values are still out of order. Now, if you observe this 42, 35, 12, they are not in order again. Okay, so what we need to do? We need to repeat this process again from first two element onwards. Again, you have to repeat the same process again. Pairwise comparisons you need to perform. Okay, so this is first step. Now we started from first two elements compared, and finally after step one, we moved the largest element to the nth position or last position. Okay, so now we repeat again step two, but this time one less comparison. That means you need to compare only first five elements now, because sixth element already, it is in sorting order. It is in its position. Okay, so one less comparison now you have to perform here, up to one to five elements only. You need to do comparisons. Okay, so now I'm performing step two, second largest element. In step two, what we'll do? Second largest element will bubble up. Okay, now I'm starting from first two elements, 42 and 35. Are they in order? That means 42 greater than 35? Yes. Okay, so that means they are not in order. Then you need to swap them. 35 comes here, 42 goes there. Okay, so then compare second and third elements. Again, same process you need to repeat, but this time only one less comparison. So 42 greater than 12? Yes. Okay, so again swap. So 12 comes here, 42 goes there. So compare next to third and fourth elements. 42 greater than 77? No. That means they are in order, so no need to swap. So then go to next two elements, fourth and fifth elements. 77 greater than 8? Yes. So you need to swap. So 8 comes here, 77 goes there. So after step 2, if you observe, the second largest element, 77, occupied its position or placed in its position. Okay, so after step 2, the second largest element placed in its position. Okay, so now remaining elements, if you observe, again they are not in order. Okay, so again you need to repeat the process for these four elements now. Okay, so two elements already placed in their positions, last two elements. Okay, so remaining four elements, now we need to arrange them in order. Okay, so that means you have to repeat the same bubble sort technique on these four elements. So I'm going to next step, step three. Okay, so step three, again I'm starting from first two element onwards. Again compare, 35 greater than 12? Yes, that means you need to swap them. So 12 comes here, 35 goes there. Okay, so then compare second and third element. 35 greater than 42? No. That means they are in order already. So no need to swap here. So then go to next two elements, third and fourth. 42 greater than 8? Yes. That means you need to swap them. So 8 comes here, 42 goes there. Okay. So now after step 3, if you see, here we'll stop here because 5th, 6th elements already arranged. So here we stop here. After step 3, the third largest element occupied its position, 42. What is the third largest element? 42 placed in its position. Okay. But whatever remaining 3 elements, they are again not in order. So you need to repeat step 4. So go to step 4. Again, start from first 2 element onwards. Always you have to start from the first 2 element onwards. So 12, 35, they are already in order. So no need to swap. 12 is greater than 35 or no? If it is, then you need to swap them. Otherwise, go to second and third element. So 35 greater than 8? Yes. So you need to swap. So 8 comes here, 35. Here we'll stop. In step 4, we'll stop here because already remaining 3 elements sorted. Okay. So after step 4, if you observe, the fourth largest number occupied its position, 35. What is the fourth largest number? 35 occupied its position. Okay. So whatever remaining, they are not in order still. So you need to repeat the next step, step 5 here. Okay. So compare first 2 elements, 12 and 8. 12 greater than 8? Yes. You need to swap. So 8 comes here, 12 goes there. Okay. So here we'll stop. Only one comparison. So then after fifth step, the fifth largest element. See, this is the first largest, second largest, third largest, fourth largest, and this is fifth largest number occupied its position. Okay. So after 5 steps, the list is sorted. That means how many numbers we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers. When you have 6 numbers, in 5 steps, the list will be sorted. Because out of 6 numbers, if you place 5 numbers in order, automatically the remaining number comes to its place. It will be arranged in its place. So that's why we use n minus 1 steps here. n minus 1 step. So after n minus 1 steps, the list will be ordered. Okay. So this is bubble sorter technique. Now, each step, just if you observe, this is the given list. This is the given list. Okay. 77, 42, 35, 12, 101, 8. So after step 1, now if you observe, these are the numbers and the last element, highest element goes to the last position. After step 2, second highest element goes to last but one position. Okay. So after step 3, third largest element goes to its position. After step 4, next largest element goes to its position. Step 5, then next largest element goes to its position. Okay. So 6 elements, 5 steps will perform. So n minus 1 steps. So in n minus 1 steps, now if you see here, the list is ordered 8, 12, 35, 42, 77, 101. This is nothing but bubble sort technique. So every time these red marks, see here. So these red color numbers, 101 is bubbled up first, then 77 is bubbled up, 42 bubbled up, 35 bubbled up, 12 bubbled up, then remaining 8. So then the numbers will be in order, we can say. So if you observe the array, this is how the numbers are sorted in the array. Okay, right? So in examination, then how to show these calculations, that is important. Okay, so sometimes the 15 marks question will be asked like this, sometimes 10 or 15 marks. Sort the following numbers using bubble sort. You are given a list of numbers. Okay, like 32, 51, 27, 85, 66, 23, 13. Now these are the given numbers. Now you need to show the calculation and you need to arrange these numbers in sorting order using bubble sort technique. Okay, so on paper, how to write each step. Okay, so now just listen carefully here. Now this is question given in question paper. So first, what you need to do when you write solution, first you copy the given numbers in the same order. 32, 51, 27, 85, 66, 23, and 13. Okay. So then step 1, step 2 calculation you need to show here. Okay. So step 1, I am showing in detail with clear explanation here. Even you can write in the examination in the same way. Okay. So in step 1, so what we need to do first, first 2 elements we need to compare. So compare 31 and 51. We should write like this in the Answer sheet. Compare 32 and 51. Since 32 is less than 51, the list is not altered. That means no need to swap here. Okay. So then second and third elements, now you need to compare. So next statement you write. Compare 51 and 27. Since 51 is greater than 27, swap 51 and 27 as below. Okay. So that means if you swap the numbers, then the numbers will be in this order. That means 27 comes here, 51 goes here. This is the order actually. Okay. So now you are swapping these two numbers. 27 comes here, 51 goes here. And you circle the two numbers. Which numbers you swapped here? Those two numbers you circle here. Okay. Now you have to compare 51 and 85. Okay. So compare 51 and 85. Since 51 less than 85, no need to alter the list. Okay. So then go to next 85 and 60. Next two numbers you need to take. So compare 85 and 66. Since 85 is greater than 66, swap 85 and 65 as below. Now if you swap, then see here. So 66 comes here and 85 comes here. These two places will be interchanged here. Okay. So these are the two numbers swapped. No? Now you circle the two numbers in the answer sheet. Okay. So then you need to compare 85 and 23 now. So compare 85 and 23. Since 85 greater than 23, swap the two numbers as below. Okay. So that means interchange these two numbers. Now if you interchange, just see here, 23 comes here, 85 goes here. These are the two numbers interchanged. So circle them. Okay. So then you need to compare now next two numbers, 85 and 13. So 85 greater than 13, no? Then again you swap these two numbers. So like this, 13 comes here, 85 goes here. So you reached the last element, no? Now this is end of the first step. Okay. So from first element to last element, you compare. After comparing all the elements, then you can observe the highest element moved to the last position. Highest element moved to the last position. Okay. So only one step we performed here. So whatever remaining numbers, see, they are not in order again. So for these numbers again, you have to perform the same process. You have to repeat the same process. Okay. So like this, you have to show the calculation in an answer sheet. Clear? Now step one finished. So after step one, 85 highest element moved to the last position. Okay. So remaining elements now I am taking, then I am performing a step two. Okay. But this time one less comparison I have to do. That means I have to stop up to 13 only. I should not disturb 85 now. So I should stop here from 32 to 13. I should compare and I should stop at 13. Now see. So step two again. So after step one, you write again step two and write the numbers again. Okay. So these are the first two numbers you need to compare, and if they are in not in order, then you circle them, because these are the numbers to be swapped. Always circle the numbers to be swapped here. Okay. So now compare first two elements. 32 greater than 27. Yes. So you need to swap them. Now see here, 27 comes here, 32 goes here. Then remaining elements as it is, you need to write here. Okay. So then just see here. So after swapping these two numbers, this is the list here. Where to circle, you need to understand here. So what you need to do, you need to compare second and third. 32 greater than 51, no change. Okay. So then 51 and 66 you compare. 51 greater than 66, no change. Then compare 66 and 23. 66 greater than 23, yes. Now that means these are the two numbers to be swapped. For them, you need to circle. Okay. No need to write again all those steps as shown in first step. Step one, you show clearly, then examiner understands that you know the concept. Okay. So from step two onwards, directly you show the numbers to be swapped here. But you need to work out on paper, and where you need to circle the numbers, you need to identify, and then you circle those two numbers. So 66 and 23. Now with these two numbers, you need to swap. 66 greater than 23. Yes, swap the two numbers. So then I'm swapping these two numbers. That means 23 comes here, 66 goes here. Okay. Then you need to compare 66 and 13. 66 and 13 you need to compare. 66 greater, yes. So you need to swap again. So 13 comes here, 66 goes here. Okay, so here we'll stop second step. So after second step, if you observe, the second largest number, 66, occupied its position. Okay, so like this, step two calculations you should write in the answer sheet. Okay, now after step two, now see here, 27, 32, 51, 23, 13, 66, 85. So 66, 85, they are in order. Now you need to perform again the same process only up to 27 to 13 again. Okay, so then I am moving on to step three. These calculations, this is how you should write in the answer sheet. Okay, so then I am going to step three. So first put the heading step three and write the numbers first. Okay, so again you go on starting your two numbers onwards. 23 greater than 32, no change. So next two elements you take. 32 greater than 51, no change. Then take next two numbers. 51 greater than 23, yes. That means these are the two numbers to be swapped. So circle them. Now you swap the two numbers. So 23 comes here, 51 goes here. Now see here. So 23 comes here, 51. Remaining elements as it is, you need to write here. Remaining elements. Okay. See here. These 66, 85 I have shown with red because just to make you understand that these are already sorted. Okay. Right. So 23 comes here, 51 goes here. So then next compare 51 and 13. So 51 greater than 13, yes, again you need to swap. So 13 comes here, 51. Only these two numbers will change. Remaining numbers you need to write as it is. Okay, so 13 comes here, 51 goes here. So then after step 3, now see, 51 is the third largest element occupied its position. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 numbers arranged in order. So for remaining numbers, again, you need to repeat step 4. Clear? So every step, when you move to next step, this is the last arrangement of the numbers. So from here onwards, you should start. Step 4, you should start from these numbers, 27, 32, 23, 13. Now see here. So at the end of step 3, the third largest number, 51, occupied its position. Okay, so now I'm moving to step 4. So 27, 32, you write all the numbers in the order. So don't touch last three numbers. Okay, so we will stop here, sir. Even you can show in examination with red color, these numbers with a red color as I have shown in a PPT. Okay, so this way, if you write in examination, examiner will give you full marks. Okay, how best you present in the answer sheet, it depends on you. There is no restriction that you should write only with blue pen or you should write only with the black pen. You can use other color pens also to demonstrate the concepts clearly. Okay, right. So step three, third largest element mode. Now step four, I'm performing here. So again, you need to start here. Don't worry about these circles. How I have drawn circles, I'll explain you. Okay. So first two onwards, first two numbers you need to compare again. 27 greater than 32, no. Okay, so then second and third, you go to next two elements. 32 greater than 23, yes. Okay, so now you circle these two numbers, 32, 23. Okay, so then you interchange these two numbers. That means these are the two numbers to be interchanged. So in the next line, immediately you write the numbers, 27 as it is, 33 comes here, 32 goes here, 23 comes here, 32 goes here. Okay, so that means these two numbers interchanged. Okay, then remaining numbers as it is. Then compare next two numbers, 32 and 13. 32 greater than 13, yes. So interchange again. So in the next step, you write the interchanged numbers. So these 27, 23 as it is, 13 comes here, 32 goes here. Then we'll stop here because these are already sorted. So after step four, the fourth largest element, 32, occupied its position. Okay, so then remaining three numbers we need to arrange. So again, write step five and write the numbers in that order. Okay, so this time 32, 51, already they are in position. So again, start from first two numbers onwards. 27 greater than 23, yes. So these are the two numbers to be swapped, circle them and interchange the two numbers. So that means 23 comes here, 27 goes here. Okay, so remaining numbers as it is. Then step next two numbers you compare, 27 greater than 13, yes. So these two numbers you circle now. Now If you interchange, 13 comes here, 27 goes here. We'll stop here after step 5. Only two comparisons we'll do here. Okay. So that means after step 5, the fifth largest element, 27, occupied its position, moved to its position. Okay. So then only two numbers left, 23 and 13. So now step 6, you write these numbers. Okay. So these are already in order. Now, first two numbers you compare, 23 greater than 13. Yes. Okay. So that means interchange these two numbers. 13 comes here, 23 goes here. Okay. So now this is the sorted list of numbers. We'll stop here because how many numbers we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7 numbers, and after step 6, then the list will be in sorted order. So finally, you draw a line here, just you write sorted list here. So 13, 23, 27, 32, 51, 66, and 85. Now this is the sorted list by using bubble sort technique. Okay, so all these 6 steps you need to write on paper this way. Okay, clear? Now we need to write program for this, whatever calculations we have done till now. Okay, so now you have to make your program to perform the same kind of calculations. Okay, so we need to write a C program for this. At the end of step 6, the 6th largest element, 23, moved to its position. Okay, so then since there are 7 elements, the list will be sorted after 6 steps or 6 passes, you can say. 6 passes, each step is called a pass. Okay, each step is called a pass, means scanning the numbers starting to ending. Okay, that is called one pass or one step. Okay, so in 6 passes or in 6 steps, the list is sorted because there are 7 elements. If your list contains 15 numbers, then you require 14 passes or 14 steps, the list will be sorted. Okay. So in this is the rule for bubble sort. If the list contains n numbers, then the list will be sorted in n minus 1 passes. Okay, so generally objective type question or in interviews, this type of question will be asked. I have some n numbers with me. Now if I perform bubble sort technique, after how many passes the list will be sorted? In worst case, this is sometimes it will not exceed n minus 1 passes. But it may end sometimes after 3 passes, after 4 passes, based on the numbers and their positions. Even after 4 passes, the list may be sorted. Okay, right? But in worst case, it requires n minus 1 passes. Okay, right. So for this, we need to write the program. Now let us write a C program for this. So I'll open code blocks here. Even online compiler, if you don't have software, online compiler you can open in your browser and you can execute your programs. You can practice your programs there. Okay, so I'm writing the comment here, program for bubble sort. Okay, so include the header file, stdio.h. Okay, so then write the main. Here we need to store the numbers in array. So that's why you declare an array A of a size some 50 or 100 you can declare. Okay, so similarly, we are not going to use all the 50 numbers. So n numbers we need to read. So declare a variable n, and to read elements into the array, we require a for loop, loop control variable you declare here. Okay, so again, to perform each step, then we require another for loop arranging of those numbers. So you require another loop control variable j there. Okay, so any more if we require, we'll add afterwards. So first, ask the user how many numbers he wants to store in the array. Okay, so say enter how many elements. Okay, so like this, you can ask the user to enter how many elements he wants to store. Okay, so read that number by using scanf function. Okay, scanf %d, comma address of n. Okay, so he wants to store n numbers. Now first, ask the user to enter n numbers. Okay, so I say enter %d numbers. Okay, comma n here. So then he enters, say for example, enter how many elements means 5. So we are asking the user to enter 5 elements. He enters some 5 numbers. Okay, so then you need to store those 5 numbers into this array. Okay, so how we can read elements into the array? By using a for loop. You can just use for I is equal to 0, I less than n, then say I plus plus. Okay, so how to read elements into the array? By using scanf function. So scanf %d and where to store each element? At address of a of what is array name? A of I. Okay, so in each position we need to store the elements. Okay, so this for loop reads elements into the array. Okay, right? So now elements are there in the array, so you need to perform a bubble sort now here. Okay, so just I'm writing the perform bubble sort. Okay, so that means on the array now you perform bubble sort. Okay, so how we can perform now here? We require two for loops, one outer for loop for number of passes or steps, step 1, step 2, step 3, you know. So for repeating each step, we require outer for loop here. Okay, so for I is equal to 0, then I less than here n minus 1 passes we require. Yes or no? Okay, so that's why I less than n minus 1. We require n minus 1. I indicates number of passes or number of steps. Okay, so we perform only n minus 1 passes, no? So that's why I value should be less than n minus 1 passes. Okay, so then again, you need to perform pairwise comparisons, no? Okay, so for that, you require another for loop, and that for loop, I'm writing inner loop. It should start from starting onwards. For j is equal to 0, and j should be less than, here it should be every time n minus 1 passes, and every time it should decrease by 1. Okay, and here I value increase by 1, no? So this I value you can take here, n minus I minus 1 or n minus 1 minus I you can take here. Okay, no doubt n minus 1 passes n minus 1 comparisons. Okay, first time it performs, see I value is equal to 0, that means first time it compares n minus 1 comparisons, because how many comparisons, pairwise comparisons you required here? For example, you have how many numbers here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so 7 numbers are there, means how many comparisons you required here? This is one comparison, first two numbers, one comparison, then next two numbers, two comparisons we require. Okay, then three comparisons here, pairwise you need to perform, four comparisons, then five comparisons, then six comparisons. So 7 numbers means you need to perform only 6 comparisons. Okay, so that's why here when I is equal to 0, that means it performs 6 comparisons. I increases 1, then it performs only 5 comparisons. I will become 2, it performs 4 comparisons. So okay, every time the number of comparisons should decrease by 1, no? Yes, so for that you need to write here j less than n minus 1 minus I here, then say j plus plus. Okay, so now you perform you do the comparison here. Now see here, so I is equal to 0, j is equal to 0. Okay, so then you need to compare the first two numbers, yes or no? So this is 0th position and this is position number 1 here. In array, it is 0th element and this is element number 1. These two numbers you need to compare. Okay, so how we'll compare here? If A of j, the first element, if A of j is greater than A of next element, how you can access j plus 1, you can say A of j greater than A of j plus 1. Okay, so that means first element and the second element. So if the first element is greater, then you need to swap the two numbers. Yes or no? See here what we did. If the first number is greater than the second number, then we swapped the two numbers here. Okay, so that means you need to perform swap operation here. Okay, so you can, if this is true, then you can write a comment here, swap. That means swap the two numbers. Okay, so for swapping of two numbers, we require another variable, temporary variable I am taking here. So you know the code for swapping of two numbers. How you can swap now? First, you store this first number. A of j is the first number. Okay, so that you catch in temporary variable. Temp is equal to A of j here. Okay, so then move the second number. First, you move the second number. This you have stored in a temporary variable. Okay, so then move the second number to first position now. Okay, so how you can do that? Now you can say A of j is equals to A of j plus 1. A of j is equal to A of j plus 1. Okay, so that means second element I am moving to first position. Okay, so then in second element position, now A of j plus 1, second element is equal to temp, you can say. Okay, because in temp you have stored the first element. Okay, right, so these two for loops together with this if condition, if the first number is greater than second number, then immediately it swaps the two numbers, otherwise it leaves and it goes to next element and next element, next two elements comparisons it performs. Okay, so please remember here I, the outer loop I is used for each pass here. See here, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4 we perform, no? For each step this, we use this outer for loop I, and in each step we are doing pairwise comparisons, no? That can be done with the inner loop here. Okay, so that's why inner loop repeats n minus 1 comparisons, then n minus 2 comparison. Every time the number of comparisons reduces by 1 here. This is the condition to be used here. Okay, so once these two loops executes, then your array will be sorted like this. Now this is the sorted array you will get here. Now this is the final sorted array you will get. So if you print a here, then you will get a values. Now print the array elements. Now what I am doing is after sorting I am printing the numbers. After sorting array elements are, okay, so just you can see the array elements are. How to print array numbers? One dimensional array numbers. So use for loop here. For I is equals to 0, then I less than n here, then I plus plus. Okay, so how we can print elements? Printf, you can just say percentage 4d, okay, comma a of I. That's it. Okay, so for your clarification, what I do is before sorting how the elements are there, after sorting how the elements are there. Okay, I print on the screen so that you can understand. Now this is entered array elements entered into the enter through keyboard. Okay, so now before I perform sorting here, now I am printing array elements. Okay, so here I'll say before sorting the array elements I am printing here, then after I am performing bubble sort here. Okay, so then after sorting I am printing the numbers here. Okay, so this is the code for bubble sort. For I is equal to 0, I less than n minus 1, I plus plus. Why n minus 1? You should understand. N minus 1 passes we required. Then for j is equal to 0, j less than n minus 1 minus I. Because every time number of passes should reduce by 1. one less comparison it has to do. So that's why n minus 1 minus I you can say here. Okay, now compare the two numbers for swap. If true, then swap the two numbers. Okay, so then these two for loops arranges the numbers in the array in ascending order. Then you print the numbers here after. Okay, so let me save this. Okay, so I name this as bubble sort. Bubble sort dot C. Okay, I'm saving this program. Now you can see the code clearly here. I have declared an array, n number of elements in the array, ij are loop control variables, a temporary variable here. So first I'm asking the user to enter how many elements. Okay, so I'm catching that in n. Then I'm asking the user to enter those many numbers into the array. Okay, so here also instead of elements, how many numbers you can use same terminology. How many numbers he wants to store into the array. Okay, so before sorting, I am printing array elements. Then I am performing sorting here. Okay, then after sorting, I am printing the array elements here. Okay, clear? Right. So as taken from our this thing. Okay, so we'll take the same numbers, question numbers 32, 51, 27, 85. I'll enter these numbers only. Okay, so we'll see whether they are sorted correctly or not by our code or not. We'll test here. So I'm building the program. So hope there are no errors. Okay, so you should also practice writing program without errors. Okay, even if there are errors, you should correct them daily. Don't afraid of errors. Now enter how many numbers. How many are there in our list? 7, no? Okay, so 7 numbers. Enter 7 numbers. So what are those numbers? 32, 51, 27. 32, 51, 27. Okay, then 85, 66, 23. 85, 66, 23, then finally 13. Okay, so just you can see here before sorting array elements are, then after sorting array elements are. Okay, so after sorting printed after this, so what we can do is we'll add a new line here. Better I add a new line here and there. Okay, so after sorting here also before A, I'll add a new line so that this entire statement goes to the next line there. Okay, so even you can add another new line. Okay, so two new lines you can use so that clearly you can see the difference. Okay, so two lines gap you can see between these statements. So again, I'm building the program. Okay, so run the program again. Enter how many numbers. Now this time you can see 7 numbers. Okay, so numbers, can you tell? 32, 51, 27. 32, 51, 27. Okay, then what about others? 85, 66, 23. 85, 66, 23, and finally it is 13. Okay, now you can see clearly. So before sorting, array elements are as it is, whatever we entered. Now this is how the array elements are initially before sorting. Then now see, after sorting, array elements are 13, 23, 27, 32, 51, 66, 85. Now they are in order, yes or no? So this order happened because of this bubble sorter technique. Okay, so whatever we performed, then that has been performed by your program, and now it has printed the numbers in order. Clear? Okay, so there are three ways of asking question on this bubble sort. Okay, so the first one, as I said, write algorithm for bubble sort. Okay, so sometimes the question may be write an algorithm for bubble sort. Then you need to explain this. You need to write this. Okay, this up to n minus 1 step. This is the algorithm. Okay, and by taking 4-5 numbers, you can show the calculation like this. Okay, simple calculation. And in that example, you should give the calculations like this. This last step, if you show like this, this is enough. Okay, step one, you perform on your own, and after step one, you write the highest element moved to last position. Then step two, individual calculations you perform, and finally you show after step two how the numbers are. Second largest element, third largest element, fourth largest, fifth largest, and after 5 steps, this is how the number is sorted. Okay, direct calculation you need to say. This is first question, 10 marks question. And the second possibility is given some numbers. Okay, so you are asked to arrange these numbers in sorting order by using bubble sort technique. And the question may be show step by step procedure also. Okay, so like this step by step procedure you need to write in your paper. Step 1, then step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, step 6. Then after finally sorted numbers you need to write like this. Okay, so each step calculations you need to show like this. Direct question, this is 15 marks or 10 marks. It's a type question. And the third possibility is write a program for bubble sort technique. C program for bubble sort technique. So then you need to write this code. Clear? Okay.